gotta save my little girl. Wait. You're sending an android?
All right, ma'am. You need to go.
You can't do that.
I know you. You're Connor. The android from that hostage situation. I thought you were dead.
Androids don't die, Captain.
My orders are to detain any androids I find. You're coming with me.
You don't understand.
Something's changed in you, Connor. Each time you died, you come back just a little colder. You show less and less empathy.
I never felt empathy, Lieutenant. I don't know what
I'm going to accomplish my mission, Lieutenant, whether you like it or not. I advise you to stay out of my way.
Did you feel anger? Hate?
He was bleeding, begging you for mercy. But you stabbed again and again and again.
You've been called the Da Vinci of our time. What do you say to that?
Absolutely ridiculous, I don't paint.
And what do you say to your other nickname, the Merchant of Death?
That's not bad.
Is it cool if I take a picture with you?
Yes, it's very cool. All right. I don't want to see this on your MySpace page. Please, no gang signs. No, throw it up, I'm kidding. Yeah, peace. I love peace. I'd be out of a job with peace.
Honestly, it's impossible.
Tony Stark was able to build this in a cave! With a box of scraps!
Well, I'm sorry.
I'm not Tony Stark.
Stark, we need a plan of attack.
I have a plan. Attack.
Is a flightless nocturnal bird that has existed in the island of New Zealand for over 30 years.
Cool.
foul line. A little vile swine, a killer by the pines. Really? Are you blind? Will you find your spines? Sick. A child decides to fill our minds with lies, and the next thing you see is people treating me like I'm committing crime. I was in my prime. Those kids were lucky to have me. Do you see what you did? But I can play along. I can be good. Do you hear that, Sid? There's a man in the woods. What do you think of that, Al? This is my perfect victory! That's right! I win!
Girl, and she wants me to duke her. I told her I'll come scoop her around 8, she said. That sounds great, shorty girl's a trooper. No matter what I needed to do, she'd be like,
blacked out, blurred, but I'm pretty sure it ruled. Damn, last Friday night.
I've been building up the blocks like a man. LA got water dripping out the ceiling. Oh my God, boy, he got a Glock. Oh my God, boy, that boy on top. Sipping water, make my heart stop. All these hoes, yeah, my love, my thigh. Yo, I let her go, put her on roll. Put that on payroll, put that on go.
Sorry, I'm told visiting hours are over.
I'm an executioner named Strath. I serve Ara at the guillotine. Don't fight. I have come here to kill you.
I see. Not pretending you want peace anymore?
We've just begun. According to Lord Lugnia, this girl is the only obstacle standing in our way. If I dispose of her now, and we get Graf Granat to trust us, this town will crumble.
I should warn you that I am fairly strong.
Stronger than me?
Stronger even than Ara the Guillotine.
You have 5 minutes until your deadline. And here you are, handcuffed to a table in a locked room.
Which is precisely where I planned on being. Captain, let me tell you a little story. You remember when I fell through your ceiling?
Yes, that was 6 hours ago.
It was, I admit, a disastrous failure. But it gave me the idea for Herman, the friendly janitor you met. With Herman, I commenced the perfect crime.
I caught you as Herman.
But you didn't catch Rosa. But now, 4 minutes is up, which means Boyle is either on the other side of that door holding your medal, or I've lost.
Excuse me, I'm here to be professionally outfitted for a jungle expedition.
Finally, a real adventurer to suit up!
So, do you like the color yellow?
Yellow?
Yeah, what are you, goofy? Yellow's the new khaki! Mike?
Really? Well, okay.
You gotta be kidding! Look at that yellow!
The new khaki.
Abu! Wow, look at that. A monkey likes to play peekaboo. Hey, this was fun, my little friend, but sorry, I gotta go. There's no stopping curiosity. I wanna turn the whole thing upside down. I'll find the things they say just can't be found. I'll share this love I find with you.
Pussy Boots! I laugh at death! You see?
Who's that?
He's here for me.
I'm Dad. Straight up. And I've come for you, Pussy Boots. Because Pussy Boots laughs in the face of death, right? What's the matter? Lives flashing before your eyes?
No. Just one. I'm done running. Fear me if you dare.
This is gonna be fun.
Than a nuclear bomb.
Words.
And the people are jealous of a man like you and me. It's as though they despise us because they are not us.
Hate us because they ain't us.
Exactly. They hate us because they ain't us. That's a great saying, okay?
Hate us because they ain't us!
They hate us because they ain't us!
What'd I do? You stole it.
Fancy. Need a vacation.
Like soul food. Parked up outside in the old school. The new me back with the OU. The dog always finds his way back home. And it's...
They didn't bring us here to change the past.
They didn't choose me, they chose her.
For what, Cooper?
To save the world.
What are we here to do?
Find out, tell her. The watch. The watch.
Parked up outside in the old school.
Wait a minute! What are you guys doing?
We're digging to Antarctica.
And Utica?
We're going to the wide open spaces of Antarctica. To the wild.
The wild? You can actually go there? Okay. I wish I could go to the wild!
The wild? Are you nuts? That is the worst idea I've ever heard.
Just imagine going back to nature, back to your roots, clean air, wide open spaces.
Papa.
But at the same time, well, nattering Noj is my friend. And he doesn't deserve to die.
Was a place called the Krusty Krab, where folks would come to eat a thing called the Krabby Patty. Every greasy spoon has a fry cook, and the one who worked here was named SpongeBob SquarePants.
But the thing that makes Woody special is he'll never give up on you. Ever. He'll be there for you, no matter what.
You have a kid, Andy. And if he wants us at college or in the attic, well, then our job is to be there for him.
Our mission with Andy's complete.
What?
And what's important now is we stay together.
We wouldn't even be together if it weren't for Andy. Look under your boot, Buzz.
Wake up! It's over!
So this is it? After all we've been through.
Wow! Nothing here to care
trouble. It's not like a Saiyan man to worry about his children. So what's gotten into you?
I don't know. Maybe it's because I'm constantly fighting, destroying, and I'd actually like to save something for once. Especially someone who's judged to be a lower class warrior, like my Kakarot.
If your father is wrong about this, then
we'll come and get you immediately.
Listen, son. You do what it takes to survive, got it?
We'll see you really soon.
Goodbye.
Those who inherited the curse of sin. The one who took that curse upon himself. On that day, the kings of the earth, and the great men, and the chief captains, and the mighty men, and every bondman, and every free man hid themselves in the dens, and in the rocks of the mountains.
What in the world?
They would all bear witness to the bare flesh of the one who is free, to the one who left it all behind, and his overwhelming intensity.
You're not the man you used to be, Zuko. You are stronger and wiser and freer than you have ever been. And now you have come to the crossroads of your destiny. It's time for you to choose. It's time for you to choose good.
Your uncle has gotten to you, hasn't he?
Yes, he has. But I've come to an even more important decision. I'm going to join the Avatar, and I'm going to help him defeat you.
Someone new must take the throne. An idealist with a pure heart and unquestionable honor. It has to be you, Prince Zuko.
I wonder, does something good ever come from living? Because there's nothing for me. In all of the days I've lived, nothing good has ever happened to me.
Do you want to die? Tell me, do you want to die, Thorfinn? Listen up! I don't know what kind of terrible things you've gone through, what kind of hell your life has been, and I never want to! But here in this hell, you're allowed to talk and you're allowed to eat. You're allowed to take a shit. You're allowed to go to sleep under a roof! And do you know why? It's because someone else allowed us to live!
That is your battle, Thorfinn! And take the ones you killed with you! It's time to fight your real battle now! Become a true warrior!
From now on, I'll never hurt anyone again. And as of today, I'm through with all violence. I'm going to be reborn, make up for it all. Everything I've done.
And now you understand, Thorfinn. You understand you don't have enemies. The truth is that nobody has them. There's nobody in the entire world who deserves to get hurt.
And that means no one here is my enemy. Because I have no enemies.
Crossover event so significant that it wasn't just one character popping into another character's story for an episode or two. No, in this crossover event, not only do we get some of our favorite characters from two universes coexisting simultaneously, we also watched as these two universes converged. Not for an episode or two, but forever, as it was revealed to us as one of the biggest anime/manga in the world was actually a prequel for one of the biggest anime/manga in the world about 10 years ago. Yes, that's right. Today we're talking about how Fire Force is a prequel to Soul Eater.
He took an axe and split himself in two.
So he would always have a friend.
So he would always have a friend.
Little donkey, take a look at me. What am I?
People take one look at me and go, ah, help, run! A big, stupid, ugly ogre.
They judge me before they even know me. That's why I'm better off alone.
I'm an ogre! You know, grab your torch and pitchforks. Doesn't that bother you?
Nope.
Really?
Really, really.
Oh.
Man, I like you.
What's your name?
Trek.
trick.
Graduation exam 3 times. Because there was this one jutsu that was always on the exam, and it tripped me up every time. It was the one jutsu that I just couldn't master. That's right, I flunked the shadow clone jutsu every time. So don't come whining to me with this destiny stuff. And stop trying to tell me you can't change what you are. Because after all, unlike me, you're not a failure.
There, you see him? It's that boy. I heard he's the only one who failed. Well, it serves him right. Just imagine what would happen if he became a ninja. I mean, he's the boy. Shh! We're not allowed to talk about that.
Chet?
This.
I can't.
Oh, yes, you can. You're right, you know. It is in you. It's always been in you. Now, I did not just face every fear known to snail kind to come down here and watch you hide in your shell. I'm sitting on a crow for crying out loud.
Don't even think about it.
Now, my little brother never gives up. That's the best thing about you. So you get out there and you win this.
Let me fix you some of this new little cocoa drink. All natural cocoa beans from the upper slopes of Mount Nicaragua. No artificial sweeteners.
What the hell are you talking about?
Who are you talking to? Tell me. Happening! Dice me? Slice me?
There's so many
choices! No! You did it! Stop that! What?
They're out of loop. They go around the block. They come back. They go around again.
Who are you? I am the creator of a television show that gives hope and joy and inspiration to millions.
And who am I? You're the star.
No one can tell you what you can or cannot do. With no rules to follow, this adventure, it's up to you.
A cigarette,
I know you'll never be mine. Can you come around tonight and sing me a lullaby? Just take my heart and break it. Can you come around tonight? I might be the enemy, but nothing quite hits like you.
Parked up outside in the old school. The new me.
Oh, that's right. What should I name the sequel? I wonder. Let's see. The Tale of Naruto Uzumaki.
Talk again.
I'm EB. And you are?
Frank.
What if I blow it?
Look, relax. I'll give you a good intro. I'll set you up and you knock him down.
What you're about to see will mystify you. It will challenge the very scope.
Cut to the chase, my friend.
I give you EB.
Up, I see the crowd mood changing by the minute, and the record on repeat. Took a sip, then another sip, then somebody said to me, nigga, why you babysitting? Only two or three shots. I'ma show you how to turn it up a notch. First you get a swimming pool full of liquor, then you dive in it. Pool full of liquor, then you dive in it. I wave a few bottles, then I watch them all fly. All the girls wanna play, they watch. I got a swimming pool full of liquor and they dive in it. Pool full of liquor, I'ma dive in it.
See, who needs flying?
Birds. Birds need flying.
Flying is freedom and not having to rely on anyone. Don't you want that?
I don't know. Sounds a little lonely.
Blue! You're flying!
Yeah!